For me, what's so special about the design process is it enables kids to learn important ideas in a meaningful and motivating way. When you're working on a design project, you're able to work on things that you really care about. And so it's, and we know that people are going to learn the ideas best when they're working on things that they that are connected to their passions and their interests. So design provides a way for kids to work on things that really become meaningful to them. It also provides a way for people to share their creations with others. As you're designing things, part of it is to create artifacts so that others can then critique it, give you feedback. So design provides a natural way to engage the social part of the learning experience.
I could certainly say no, not everybody needs to teach with design thinking, because design thinking is merely one method of creative problem solving in an applied context. Yes. Totally. I haven't seen a really great alternative that includes clear language, that really incorporates this idea of empathic understanding of other people and how to solve their problems. Nor have I seen a really great method that crosses disciplines, that allows people to iteratively try to solve problems, try out different things, fail. Nor have I seen something that really allows students to kind of explosively brainstorm. I like how design thinking brings all of that together.
Design thinking is probably the most important thing, I think, to include in any curriculum, no matter what you're teaching. Anything from how you analyze a problem that's been given to you, to understanding the fact that when you get out of school, there are no problems that are really given to you. You have to figure out what the problems are. And the more advanced you get, the more you've got to figure out to define your own problem, then solve it yourself. If you're trying to figure out how to solve problems about clean water, or infrastructure problems, or developing new solutions for different kinds of medical issues. It's all design thinking that allows us to solve these problems in really big, important ways. And the earlier you learn that, the more effective you'll be as you get older doing it.
You know, education, I would argue, in the 19th century was really about rote memorization, was about ingesting a certain amount of content and then being able to repeat that content in a very cogent and succinct and accurate way. Now we have computers and we have the internet and we have this entire repository of information that keeps all of this stuff for us. So our brains no longer have to contain this information. What our brains have to be able to do is to recall and pull that information when it becomes relevant to whatever it is we're doing. I think that is a fundamental skill of a designer.
Design is also inherent in so much of the work that we all do, and it's more in kind of the details and looking at ways of how we can improve things or reassess things. And I think that mindset is really important in many different subject areas, and a lot of teachers and educators are actually doing this sort of subconsciously, but when you bring it to the forefront and make it a really strong aspect of the learning process, you'll see that the students are highly engaged and motivated because they see that they have, they're empowered to be able to make decisions and to be using their learning in a really fruitful way.
And I think educators already know that from you know, decades and centuries before, is that students getting hands-on in project-based learning that has a real-world application for another person is the best way for them to learn. So it's kind of sad that we've had to have this new way of talking about something that we just know is good teaching. So to me, design thinking is good teaching and is good learning. And if we're not incorporating this into our experiences for our students, we're really missing the opportunity that we have with them to help them approach the world in a different way.
Educators should care about design thinking because it adds a fresh new approach that can be applicable to students in many different ways. It brings, first of all, some ownership to students in their learning, but it also brings a lot of relevancy. So students can actually feel like they're contributing to something that they're learning and also solving a problem, possibly for themselves. It might be for somebody else that they know. It might even be community-based. So I think once a teacher learns about that process, they're going to see there's so many different ways that they can actually bring it into the students' learning.